ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सहवीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्तिः शान्तिः शान्तिः। त्वमेव माता च पिता त्वमेव बन्धुश्च सखा त्वमेव विद्या द्रविणं त्वमेव सर्वं मम देव त्वमेव सर्वं मम देव। कृष्णाय वासुदेवाय हरये परमात्मने प्रणतक्लेशनाशाय गोविंदाय नमो नमः गोविंदाय नमो नमः। सो लेट अस गो थ्रू टिल नाउ व्हाट यू हैव सीन। द स्टोरी ऑफ महाभारत स्टार्टेड विथ विश्वामित्र एंड विश्वामित्र there was a king, his name is Kusnav, and he married to one damsel, one celestial nymph. His name is Purukutsa, and they had two children. One is a son, one is a daughter. The son's name is Gadhi, and daughter's name is Satyavati, not Santanu's wife Satyavati. It is a different Satyavati. And Satyavati got married to a king called Ruchika. And then Ruchika wanted, as a king, he wanted a very strong and who is very courageous king. So he did a, actually Ruchika is a rishi. He's a rishi. He wanted a strong child. At that time, rishis, they were also they were leading household life. They were helping in the ruling the kingdom, or they are ruling the kingdom. There are different things they were doing. This Ruchika wanted a very strong son, so he did a yajna, and from that, the chalu, whatever the sacrificial that offering or the sacrificial chalu, what he got, he divided between. Actually, he gave to his wife Ruchika, to Satyavati. His wife is Satyavati, but Satyavati's mom also asked one part, so he gave little to Satyavati's mom. Then Satyavati's mom changed the chalu with Satyavati. So what was given to Satyavati now is consumed by Satyavati's mother, and whatever was given to Satyavati's mother is now taken by Satyavati. From Satyavati, Jamadagni was born, and from Satyavati's mother, Vishwamitra is born. Then Vishwamitra, he ruled for hundreds of years, and he ruled really very well. At the end, he gave up all the kingdom and everything. Then he did the penance and meditation, and he was doing a lot of austerities and a lot of tapasya. Then Indra sent Menaka to break his penance or his austerities, his tapasya. Then at the end, Vishwamitra and Menaka married, and Shakuntala was born, the daughter Shakuntala. Vishwamitra left Shakuntala, and Kanva Rishi took care of Shakuntala. Then Dushyanta came, Dushyanta king, he came there, Bharata Vamsa, Dushyanta, and then Bharat was born. In that Bharat was born. In that same dynasty, there was a king called Santanu, and he got married to Ganga and to Satyavati. Now, why Santanu and Ganga, what is the why they are, what they were in the previous life? That we will see later in the next class. But today, we'll see regarding the Vidur's marriage. Already we have discussed the birth of Pandu and Dhritarashtra. Already we have seen, but last time we didn't discuss the Vidur's birth. When Bhagavan Vyasadeva, after his birth, and he went to, he lead a monastic life. He was entirely devoting his time in meditation on the Lord. He didn't go to the household life. But Pandu was married to Kunti, and Dhritarashtra to Gandhari, was married. Then the Vidura, Vidura was born, like Dhritarashtra and Pandu, Vidura was also born from on behalf of Bhagavan Vedavyasa. When Satyavati saw that the children, her own children, Chitrangada and Vichitravirya, they have no children, because Chitrangada died and Vichitravirya he could not have any children. He married to Ambika and Ambalika, but no children. Chitrangada died in the war, and he died with the war with the Gandharva, Chitrangada, and Vichitravirya died of disease. So no children. So now there is nobody to rule, take the throne, because Bhishma Pitamaha, he has promised that he will not marry and he will not also take the throne. Now there is a big problem. Satyavati was, and Santanu in the meantime, he died. Santanu had told Satyavati that the kingdom should be ruled very well and it should go nicely. The people are to be taken care of. But now there is no king. So Satyavati requested, actually not requested, serially commanded Bhishma to take the throne. Of course, he ruled for some days, but that is not the way. That should be a proper king, because he didn't want to become the king at all. That promise he has given to Satyavati's dad, whose name is Dasaraj, that the fisherman, that I will not marry or I will not rule the, I will not sit on the throne. In that condition, Satyavati was married to Santanu. So he is keeping that promise. But when Satyavati saw that there is no children are born from her children, then Bhishma is the child of Gangadevi. Vichitravirya died and Chitrangada died. So now there is nobody to rule. So she requested, or not requested, she commanded Bhishma to sit on the throne and to rule the kingdom. He denied. He told, I will support, but I will not rule the kingdom. Then now she is in great difficulty, because what Santanu has told, she cannot keep that promise. Then she told to Bhishma Pitamaha to call Vyasadeva. Then Bhishma Pitamaha went to Vyasadeva. Vyasadeva was in meditation. Of course, he knew why he has come and everything, because he is the Trikaladarshi. Vyasadeva came and he told, you know, to Bhishma Pitamaha, at that time Bhishma, that you didn't obey to Satyavati because you are not her son. But I am born from her. So as a son, it is the greatest duty of the son to always listen to mom. If mom is telling something, the child has to listen. Though he was not interested, Vyasadeva was not interested in the family life at all, but he has to come. He knew why Satyavati is calling. Then she came. Satyavati requested him to have children from Amba and Ambalika, because their husbands died. Not Amba and Ambalika. अंबिका एंड अंबालिका, देन भगवान व्यासदेव ही इज एबल टू सी व्हाट इज गोइंग टू हैपन इन द फ्यूचर, सो ही एग्रीड टू दैट. देन फर्स्ट अंबा वाज सेंट टू व्यासदेव, व्यास भगवान, बट सी व्हेन सी सॉ हिम and his look was not that good, and again beard and everything of the jata, so she just closed her eyes, and in the meantime the transfer of energy has already happened. So Vyasadeva told to Ambika that since you closed your eyes, so the child will be a blind child. See the thing, what is the last thought during the conception time, what is the last thought of the mother, that will have lot of influence on the child. That is very important. That's why they create a sattvic atmosphere. For so many days they do prayer to have a child, otherwise this thing happens. Then anyhow, Ambika went, and Vyasadeva told to Satyavati that this thing happened and the child will be a blind one. Then she felt bad. Then another chance is there, Ambalika is there. So, and Satyavati warned her that don't close your eyes or anything. So she was very careful. And when she came, and by seeing him, she didn't close her eyes, but she became completely pale. Her complexion would become very dull. And she became complacent because she got so frightened. As a result, the child which was born, and the Vyasadeva, your child will be sick child. It will be a pale child. It will be a sick child. And that he mentioned to Satyavati also. And Satyavati was very much worried and requested him that give another chance. I will send another time. Vyasadeva agreed because he wanted to fulfill the promises of Satyavati or his mother. Then when he told Ambika and Ambalika, they discussed among each other. They told that Ambika told that I will not go. Ambalika told that I will not go. Then now, but the mother has, the chief queen has told, who is the, she is the head. She is the Rajrani. So since she has told, it has to be followed. Then what they did, they have the maid servant, and her name is I will tell her name. So she was sent. Just 1 second, let me see the name of that. She was sent. And then the maid servant, she went to Bhagavan Vyasadeva, and she treated him, she bowed down, and she, with lot of respect and everything, she went. And by seeing her love and seeing her respect and her mannerism, Vyasadeva was very pleased. And then he blessed her with the child. And that child was Vidura. And then he came and told to Satyavati, do you know this thing happened? Satyavati didn't know that the maid servant is sent. But anyhow, at the end, the child which was going to be born in the future will be a very a child of moral values, and he'll be very good in he'll be a righteous person, and he will have good knowledge regarding the what dharma is. And Vidura was born. And once the three children are born, then when they become little bigger, Bhishma Pitama took all the three children to to his place, and then in the same country but in different place, then he taught them everything regarding politics, regarding the warfare, because the Kshatriyas. And when they become bigger and are very good, then they are brought to the palace. Satyavati, Ambika and Ambalika, they are sitting. And all the three children, they were brought. Satyavati asked, where are the children? They told, no, they are now here. They are coming. And once they came, now who is the king now? Bhishma Pitamaha told that Dhritarashtra will be the king because he was the older one. But Vidura told her, no, he will not be the king because he is blind. He cannot rule the country. So he will not be the king, Vidura told. Then Dhritarashtra really agreed to Vidura. He told her, yes, I am blind. I cannot even take care of myself. How can I take care of the people? So let Pandu become the king. Then Satyavati asked Bhishma Pitamaha, what is your opinion? Then Bhishma Pitamaha didn't tell anything. He told her, no, you are the queen and you are to tell. I will not tell. I will only protect the whoever rule the king. I will help them to rule the country and I will protect against the attack from the other countries. But you are to tell. Then Satyavati told her, okay, Pandu is the king. Pandu became the king from that day. This is the story regarding Vidura. Now, where from Satyavati came? That is, I read a beautiful story regarding Satyavati. So that's why I want to tell. Satyavati, there was a king. His name is actually Vasu. His name is Vasu, but he had very good relationship with Indra. And Indra and they were so close. Indra will send his own chariot for the Vasu to come to Indrapuri. And since always he was frequently visiting Indra in his chariot, that's why his name become Uparichara means Upari means in the sky. Chara means moves. That means he was going so many times to Indra from the earth to heaven. So his name become Uparichara Vasu. His name was really Vasu, but later he was known as Uparichara Vasu. In the there was a there was another she's the actually a celestial lady and like a apsara, and this Uparichara Vasu got married to, and her name is Girika. Yeah, her name is Girika. So he married to Girika. Why he married? Because Uparichara Vasu ruled the kingdom for so many years. He also left. These kings are always, they rule and then at the end they take to sannyas. And he did so severe penance. All the devatas and Indra, they were scared. Now Indra is his best friend, but now he's scared of him that he will take his post. So he himself came with all other devatas and requested him that you give up this penance. Give this penance and always I will help you. So this Uparichara Vasu listened to Indra because they are good friends, and then he ruled the kingdom again. And because of the help of Indra, he conquered Chedi and became the Chedi king. The kingdom of Chedi he conquered. At that time, in the advice of Indra, he married to Girika. That is, she's a damsel. He got married to Girika. Then once they are in love, the Uparichara Vasu and Girika, but suddenly the ancestors, they appeared. And they're in love in a garden, but suddenly they appeared. And they told that, you know, our Shraddha is there. So you please offer the deer meat in that Shraddha. And he has to listen to his ancestors. So the Uparichara Vasu, he left Girika when they're in the middle of love. And then he went in after a deer to hunt the deer. But he came to a tree, and near the tree he smelled something extremely fragrant. Suddenly all the desire and the lust came in his mind, and he wanted to meet his wife, but his wife is now away. because he left her in the garden. Then now he's in this place. And he has, then the semen came out. And when it came out, he wanted to, he didn't want to destroy it. So he collected in a leaf and made a packet. And there was an eagle sitting on the tree. And he caught hold of the eagle and told to the eagle that you take this one and give it to Girija, his wife. Then the eagle is taking. In the meantime, another eagle came, and that other eagle thought that is a piece of meat, so he wanted to snatch it away. So when they're fighting like this in the sky, in the space, it fell down. It fell down in a river. But in that river, there was another damsel who was cursed. Why she was cursed? Because these apsaras, they always marry the Gandharvas. They marry Gandharvas. The Gandharvas and the apsaras, there was a river, and they always come to that river, in the Yamuna river actually. They come there every day in the evening. So that's why in the evening time nobody goes there. But one Brahmin, in order to do his evening rituals, a poor Brahmin had gone there to the Yamuna river. At that time, this damsel and the Gandharva, they didn't really like his presence, the Brahmin's presence. And when he was standing in the water, the Brahmin is standing in the water. So this this damsel, she, or this apsara, went inside the water and pulled his leg. And when the poor Brahmin, he drowned in the water. When he came, realized that this thing has happened, so he cursed that apsara. Her name is Adrika. Adrika. Now, Adrika stayed in the Yamuna river as a fish, because now she's cursed, she's staying there. But when the semen from Uparichara fell in the river from the eagle's mouth, at that time this fish swallowed it. And this fish was caught by the fisherman whose name is Dasaraja. Dasaraja, I told you just now, Dasaraja, he's the chief fisherman in that area. In his net, this fish was a big, huge fish. When he caught it open, he saw two human children. One is a boy, one is a girl. This girl, then he took both the children and went to the king, to Uparichara Vasu. Uparichara Vasu told them, kept the boy, and girl he gave back to Dasaraj. So you take care of the girl, because of the king, he needs a future king, that's why he kept. And he made that, when that boy become little bigger, then he made the commander in chief of the army. And now the daughter is being taken care by Dasaraj. Since she was born from the fish, so she was smelling fish. That's why her name is, in the beginning, her name is was Matsyagandha, because she was smelling like fish. But the story already I have told. Since she was the daughter of a fisherman, she was helping dad by ferrying people across the Yamuna river. Then Parasramani came. And then she told that, he told, and she was taking Parasramani from this side to the other side. Parasramani told that you are going to become the architect of the future of this country. And a great soul is going to born from you. She told, no, I'm a virgin girl. I'm not married. How can I have children? He told her, no, I'll help you to have a child. And he told her, it cannot be. Without my dad's permission, it cannot be. Then But anyhow, she was afraid that her virginity will be lost. So that's why Vyasadeva promised her, no, your virginity will not be lost. And again, your the fish smell will go away. Then he became the her name become Yojana Gandha. Matsya Gandha become Yojana Gandha. Yojana means 8 miles. That means she will have so much of fragrance from 8 miles one can detect her presence because she will smell so good. And you know the story that how Santanu, when he was going through the forest, he could smell that. The presence of Yojana Gandha. Her name is actually Matsya Gandha. Her name is also Satyavati. Then he got married. That story already you know. Last time also I was telling regarding the Pandu, after he married, he went for the Vana Vihar. In the Vana Vihar, he came across, just 1 second, because the name's little. There, Ambika and Ambalika, they also went to Vana Vihar because now he is the king and he gave the kingdom to Dhritarashtra and he went for Vana Vihar just to have a retreat for some days. And in that place, there was like a deer. And Ambalika, who is the younger one, he insisted when they are going to take lunch actually, but he insisted that the deer is there. Then Pandu went in search of that deer. And then he sought, but actually he sought the rishi and his wife, they were in love with each other. And it pierced their heart and they died. Before dying, they cursed. And his name is Kindamarusi. Kindamarusi, actually, he has only blessed in the marriage of Pandu, but now he is killed by Pandu. So he cursed that you cannot, whenever you go for a relationship with your wife, if you go near her, then you will die. So that they, both of them, they know. Kunti, Ambika and Ambalika, they very much aware of that one. So they were not, no, sorry, I'm telling. Kunti and Madri, Kunti, Pandu's wife, Kunti and Madri. So they are very much aware of that this curse. So that's why he was never coming near them. They were not going near him. But one day when Kunti was away, Pandu came very close to Madri. As a result, that day he died. Of course, that came later. But when he, from the Vana Vihar, when he came back, now he's cursed. Then he didn't want to rule the kingdom. He gave back to few days he ruled and he gave to Dhritarashtra. He told, I want to be free from this sin, from this crime which I have committed. So I will leave the kingdom and he will go for penance. So he went for penance. There all the children were born. There are the five from Kunti that I have told that story. That by the blessings of different devatas, she has got the 3 children and Madhuri 2 children, 5 children. Then in the forest he died because he went closer to Madhuri and he died. Then Madhuri also jumped into that funeral pyre because Sati, and she died. Now Kunti came back to the kingdom. That story. The next story I was going to tell of how the 100 brothers are, Kauravas, how their number became 100. When Gandhari is the daughter of the king of Gandhara. And there, one Bhagavan Vedavyasa is in everything. He had come to kingdom of Gandhara. There, at that time, Gandhari was in, she was given the responsibility to take care of Bhagavan Vyasadeva, who, and Bhagavan Vyasadeva was so impressed with her treatment, then he blessed her. And he wanted to give her a boon. Then Gandhari told her, give me, I want 100 sons. Then he told Tathastu, and he left. Then she got pregnant, but no child is born. In this way, 2 years went, but nothing is born. But she got pregnant, only 2 years had gone. And at the end of 2 years, a lump of flesh was born. So she got so scared. How is this like a bundle of flesh? That no children, nothing. 100 children she had asked. Then she wanted to throw that one because it is a bad thing. And just she gave birth to a lump of flesh, so she threw that. And in the meantime, Bhagavan Vyasadeva came. She was going to throw, but Bhagavan Vyasadeva said, no. This is the 100 children you have asked. This is 100 children. How is this a bundle of flesh? Then Bhagavan Vyasadeva said, no, cut into 100 pieces. Actually 101 pieces, and put inside bottle. There in some bottles, ghee and this little place was kept in, and they become 100 children, and one girl, and her name is Dusala. So they have 100 sons and one daughter. When the Shakuni, I think this story already I have told. Shakuni, he wanted the way his entire family was killed, was to death. Actually, they are starved to death by Dhritarashtra. So he wanted to take revenge. That story already I have told. Okay. Now, Shakuni left his kingdom and he wanted to help Gandhar. In the name of helping, really, he wanted to destroy the entire Kaurav dynasty. So he came there, and he's the brother of the wife. So he was allowed in the kingdom, because that was the promise of Gandhari's dad. Before death, he told Dhritarashtra that my son, who was the only son who got, he has also 100 sons. But Shakuni was alive, and he will take care of my daughter. So Dhritarashtra allowed Shakuni to come to Hastinapur. But while Gandhari was not really happy with his brother, because his brother is very conniving. He will always create division between the Kauravas and Pandavas, and he will not give them to stay as brothers. And always he'll try to pollute the mind of Duryodhana from the childhood days. And he wanted Duryodhana to become the king. And when it came that Yudhishthira, because Yudhishthira was born first, though Dhritarashtra was the older son, but Yudhishthira was born first. That means he will become the future king, because he is the older one. That didn't go well with Shakuni. So Shakuni always polluted the mind of Dhritarashtra and Duryodhana. He was telling that these five brothers, they are going to take over everything, and you will be nothing, but I don't want to see that one. We have to do something. So as per Shakuni's advice, when they're small, even they're in the school, he poisoned Duryodhana's mind to kill one of the brothers, and particularly Bhima, because Bhima is the strongest one, so Bhima has to be killed. But how he'll kill? Because he liked food very much. So food is the only way to kill him. Then one day, in the all the brothers, the five brothers and 100 Kauravas, Pandavas and 100 Kauravas, they are staying in the ashram, they are learning. In the meantime, one day, Bhima was not feeling well. He was just feeling bored. Then he was sitting. Then Duryodhana came and told that, why you are, everybody is playing, why you are here? Duryodhana, Dushasana always they will plan on the advice of Shakuni. Now I am feeling bored. Now I have kept poison for you. Then come and take. Then Bhima went and they have put poison in the poison. And then Bhima ate that one and he really died. Then without anybody's knowledge, these two, they took that small body and threw in the river Ganga. And in the, at the bottom of the Ganga is the Matsya Desa. Is the Matsya Desa. That means all the, and it will come later, that they were in the Indraprastha. So now they are staying below the river Ganga. Then this Bhima's body went down and down and down. At the end, not Matsya Desa, it is called Nagaloka. Nagaloka. The Nagas, previously they were in Indraprastha, but they were driven out by Arjuna and Bhagavan Sri Krishna. So they are staying in the below the Ganges. So in the Nagaloka, the body reached there. It is unconscious, not dead, unconscious, reached there. The Nagalokas, they thought that this is some intruder or some spy. So they started biting. When they bite, all the poison went away and he became alive. Then he was taken to the king. And the king asked him, who are you? Then he told that I am the son of Kunti. Then he really liked it because somehow he related to Kunti in a distant relation. Then he took very good care and gave him some kind of ambrosia. And he told that you take this one cup of this thing, you will be, your strength will be equal to 10 elephants. Then he ate that one. And here everybody is looking for where Bhima is, but nobody is getting. And Kunti is very much worried. All the brothers are, they're very much worried. And suddenly Bhima came because he is alive. And by hearing that, Dushasana and Duryodhana, they are very much worried that how he was, he came to life. Only the Nagas they can only save, but how he going to Nagaloka? But anyhow, he survived, and that really created a lot of anger in the and jealousy in the mind of Shakuni, Duryodhana and Dushasana. And when Dhritarashtra came to know that he came back, he was not happy. Always he was not happy, but he would show as a himself as a good guy, as the caretaker of the Pandava brothers. But in the heart of heart, he didn't really want them. So this is the story regarding Bhima. So the rivalry between Bhima and Duryodhana started from the very beginning. It is because of Shakuni. And after that, what happened, that we'll see next time. Okay, Hari Om. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hari Om. Hari Om.